other things to get you through the day. Job. Music. Friends.
Maybe we could go up to the lake, rug up, and we could probably get some really good quality time together in.
Sure.
My pregnant daughter and I have had an accident. I need emergency medical assistance.
When the sun goes down, it's going to get really cold, really fast.
Your body's probably having a really hard time keeping you warm. I'm going to leave for help.
What?
We've got a storm coming in.
You're having contractions. If anybody can hear me, please come here.
And the baby's hungry.
Boom, there you go. That was the trailer for Frost arriving to digital platforms as well as Blu-ray on October 11th. I'm Kuya P. This is Nerds Rule the World. And as you see on the screen, I have a special guest coming from his car, Brandon Slagle, the director of Frost. Thank you so much for your time today, Brandon.
Thank you very much for having me.
Definitely.
And let me give a shout out to Zoa Energy Drink while I'm at it. I just realized I had this in my hand.
No worries. We got to keep energized. We got to get that energy up and keep it moving. Again, I want to thank you. I actually got the DVD. You guys sent it over to me in advance. So thank you for that. Had the opportunity to check it out. Let's talk about it. Let's talk about how it came to the people. You worked along this with your amazing wife, Devanny Pinn, who I'll also have an interview on the channel very soon with her as well, talking about Frost. But why did you guys choose to make this your next project?
So this is a project that we did during COVID, like during the height of COVID. And we had had other things that we were doing that we were scheduled to do before everything happened, and they got canceled. It's interesting because I think a lot of the bigger companies that were doing these movies, when a pandemic happened, they didn't really know how to handle it, or they didn't know what content to create. So a friend of ours, James Cullen Bressack, and Cleopatra Entertainment, who's the same company as Cleopatra Records, which I grew up listening to in high school and college, wanted to get something done. So James had actually heard of a story happened in China. He had read an article about it, happened, I think, in 2017. Although I could be wrong. And he had gotten together with Brian Pereira at Cleopatra and came to Devanny and I to put the project together. And we had access to wooded areas and other places like that because we were slightly outside of LA. So it's really something that kind of made sense because it was a chance to first have a project done during the pandemic. And also it was a challenge because I've been doing a lot of things lately that are really big in scale, and this is small and contained. And even though that sounds easy, it's actually pretty challenging to figure out how to keep something interesting that's literally in the car through most of the movie.
I feel that as a filmmaker myself, I know that wholeheartedly. So you get with your wife, you determine, okay, this is what we want to do. Tell me about a little bit about that pre-production, like reaching out to, you know, friends and family, because we are filmmaking during the pandemic. How hard was it to get some of the cast? And tell me about some of those additional cast members that you had along with Devanny.
So James, Devanny, and I came up with the beats that we were going to hit in the movie and the story. And then we hired a friend of mine named Robert Thompson, who had written a movie I did a few years ago called Crossbreed, to actually write the first couple drafts of the script. And he did that. He kept it. I think what we actually filmed is about 90% of his original draft. And then we went and we altered it based on what was available to us. Vernon, who plays Devanny's father, was also actually in Crossbreed. People may know him from Mad Max the Road Warrior and Commando and Weird Science and all of those movies that, you know, people grew up with and love. I love to drop the lid off some Steve Bennett jokes to him at an opportune time because it annoys him. He's like, I don't know if I can curse here, but that's what he does. But he likes it, and he's a friend. So the two of them and another friend of ours named Venus DeMilo Thomas, she's the girl in the very beginning that's basically making sure that Devanny's character is okay. We really just got together, got a very, very small crew. I think maybe 7 or 8 people, which is not what I'm used to anymore. And really dug back into those like grassroots filmmaking techniques that we all came up on. Because like Devanny and myself and James, all of our original movies, we really did ourselves with, like you were saying, friends and family. And so it was an interesting opportunity to get back into that mindset and really just be creative and clever with what we had at our disposal.
I love that. I love that. That return to guerrilla filmmaking. I know that wholeheartedly. I've been that those up and downs as an independent guy. So let's talk about some of those lessons learned. I have a lot of filmmakers that watch a lot of my interviews and what I'm doing. And there's a lot of pro tips that we dole out. What were some that you kind of learned along the way, having to go back in that vein? Tell me about the actual production. How long did it take? And kind of figuring that out. Like you said, you figured out your shots already a little bit in advance, but just maybe break down the production a little bit.
Yeah. So we still ended up shooting it really quickly. And like I said, we did not have a very large crew. And we had, a COVID officer, a DIT, a very like skeleton camera crew and sound and effects. And that was, and costumes and makeup. And that was it. Costumes and makeup was the same person. The camera crew was like 3 people. So it was, like I keep saying, really just making sure the chemistry was there. Like, you can have all the tricks in the world up your sleeve, but if you don't like each other and you don't know how to gel and vibe, then none of it's going to work. So you have to make sure that you can get in people's heads. And I'd say above all, that applies to every movie. That doesn't just apply to this. That applies to bigger movies, just commercials, short films, anything you do. Chemistry is so, so, so important. Production wise, we shot this and, it's basically 2 people and one other person for one scene. We shot this in totality in like 8 days. Most of the days were spent in the opening scenes of Devanny and Vernon in Vernon's house, and then all the scenes in the car and Vernon wandering the woods were the rest of the scenes. And then all of the insert shots, that's like Devanny's character's hand reaching for like the power button in the car and stuff like that, shot that, and the opening where she's driving over a couple of extra days after just her and I, after we had already wrapped the movie. Yeah, it's really just like we keep saying, it's hitting the ground running and just go, get it done. I have a very like particular style I like to shoot. So that was with a lot of like dolly and movement and stuff like that. So that was, it was interesting trying to get those setups in such a short amount of time. But the DP, Kelton Jones, actually comes from shooting miniatures and stuff like that and special effects. So he actually understood how to move quickly and make and cheat a lot of perspective and do other things that, even though this was, like a car parked alongside a ditch with fake snow, it still looks big and it looks like a big world. There's a shot you see a few times that's a dolly shot going left and right with the car kind of in the background and snow in the foreground, where literally we just had snow in the foreground and on the trees, but everywhere else was 65 degrees. So it was just using everybody's aptitudes and just getting it done, not sitting around second guessing everything, just, jumping in head first and shooting a movie.
Making art, that's what it's about, especially in crazy pandemic times. I love that you guys were able to get this done. And now it's here, available again, everybody, on October 11th in digital as well as Blu-ray. Before we get up out of here, so now that it's out, what has the vibe been, post since it wrapped? I don't know if you screened it before this release now. What has been the reception like from the cast and crew?
So we screened it at the North Hollywood Cinefest last night. Which is the closing night film. And this one's interesting because the end of the movie could be very divisive to some people. And whether they like it or dislike it, it will get people talking and attract eyes. There's actually a couple of reviews that came out that said it was shocking and revolting. And I don't know if the reviewers realized that that's actually an endorsement. Because people just go, oh, I wonder why it's so shocking and revolting. Unfortunately, I was able to introduce the movie, but I couldn't stay for the screening. But Bressack and Devanny both watched it and said that it was well received, that the ending did what it needed to do. And as far as I'm concerned, if it continues to get that reaction, that's when you're successful. That's when you've done your job, is when a movie accomplishes its goal.
I love that.
No.
Well, there we go, everybody. Again, Frost opens on October 11th on digital and Blu-ray. Again, shout out to Brandon Slagle, man. Thank you for your time. My love to your wife, Devanny. I will have that interview up on the channel as well, talking all about Frost. Is there any other projects now post this? Because I know you kind of got, you had to chill out a little bit because of the pandemic. And yeah, this was like one of the first films coming out of the pandemic where you started rolling again. Is there any other shine we can throw on some of those other projects and or throw some socials out there for people to check you out?
So what's funny is I was getting antsy because we had projects get canceled. And so this project was shot last March 2021. And then I ended up getting hired to do one May, June 2021 called Arena Wars. That's should be out of post soon. It's kind of a Running Man, or if you remember the video game Smash TV.
It's like and Running Man. I love all of that right there.
Yes, with a lot of martial arts. And then in November of last year, I did a movie called Breakout with a very dear friend of mine, Louis Mandalore, as the lead. It's basically like a Die Hard in a prison. A prison break. I ended up just getting lucky after a dry spell and working back to back to back, because after Breakout the next month, I did another movie with Lewis and Casper Van Dien and Jeff Fahey called Battle for Saipan, which is a World War II action movie. And that actually comes out in theaters next month.
Awesome.
Through Saban and Paramount. And then after that, that movie was done in Thailand. And then a few months after that, I went back to Thailand again, once again with Lewis and also Casper and Nikki Whalen, to do a movie called The Flood, which is sort of Assault on Precinct 13 meets Crawl. And then there's a couple other movies. That's also for Saban. And there's a couple other movies that I wrote, one called 3 Days in Malay. That's another war movie that Lewis actually directed. And then I did some revisions on a movie called The Midway Point, which is a coming-of-age drama with Thora Birch and Wes Studi. So I got really busy after
Love
this. And I was lucky because it doesn't always go that way.
True.
Like I said, next, so Frost comes out next week, October 11th, and Battle for Saipan, which is a really, really martial arts-heavy, brutal World War II action movie. Mostly thanks to Lewis. If anyone's seen The Debt Collector or any of his other movies, you know that he's not just a heartthrob from My Big Fat Greek Wedding. He can actually throw down. That comes out in theaters November 25th.
I love that.
And then things are all to be determined, but they'll all be out within the next year.
Awesome. What are yours? Do you have a socials, websites I can put? I'll have it in the description below, but for those that might be listening to this while driving, how they can check you out?
Yeah. Just my name, Brandon, BrandonSlagle. That's the same. That works for Instagram, for Facebook, for Twitter, although I don't use Twitter that much. And then I don't do TikTok or anything like that.
That's for the young squad.
I'm my 40s are half over. I can't do TikTok.
I feel you on that, Brandon. Thank you again for your time. Everybody, I will have all of those links in the description below so you can check out Brandon. Make sure you send him some follows. Louis Mandalore is actually a friend of the channel. He's a friend with one of my other guys on the show. We've had him interviewed a couple times. I forgot those projects. So as those other projects come through, I'd love to have you back. And I'm going to reach out to my friend Rob, who's friends with Louis, to maybe have him back on to talk about it. We'd love to chat those up.
He's one of my oldest, dearest friends. I've known him almost as long as a lot of my family. So that would be awesome.
That would be beautiful. So, guys, stay tuned to the channel. We'll make that happen. Everybody, again, Brandon Slagle, Frost drops on digital platforms as well as Blu-ray on October 11th. Make sure you check it out, as well as Battle of Saipan, all these other amazing projects. I will get with Brandon to get that all scheduled up. We'll talk about it, and hopefully we'll have Lewis on as well. Yes. Thank you so much, Brandon. Appreciate your time.
Yeah, thank you very much. And drink Zoa.
There you go. Endorsement. Get him that endorsement deal, Zoa. He deserves it. It's your boy Kuya P. This is Nerds Rule the World.
Oh, my God.